Well, hello to all of you as we enter into the season of light and hopefully the season of ever greater love. We want to talk about that today. Today has been an exquisite Florida day. Perfect temperature, perfect breeze, perfect shadows as the sun is further south in the sky, and it's just gorgeous. So I couldn't help but arrange to be outside some today. So when I came in, I thought, okay, now I've got to figure out what I'm going to do for the new podcast, because I need to get that to Robert so he can do his part and get that up and ready before he goes off on vacation. So what am I going to do? Well, I discovered that my answer was on my computer. I walked in my door and went over to the computer, and in whatever few number of seconds it took all that to happen, and found an email from a friend in Great Britain with a link to his blog. And his blog included a statement by the Danish philosopher Martinus. I guess that's how you pronounce his name. In any event, it was just exquisite. And I thought, well, there you go. This is what I need to do a podcast about today. So as an aside, it's pretty interesting to see how whatever you need shows up in record time. I thought 30 seconds was pretty good from what am I going to do to here's the answer. So this gentleman had an experience when he was 30 years old, which was back in 1921. He grew up in a poor family, illegitimate son of a young woman, and raised by foster parents, poorly educated, as we would understand such things. So he hardly got off to a great start in terms of what we would think might be a necessary background for a revelatory experience. As often happens to people, this just seemed to appear out of the blue. And yet we know that there aren't any accidents. So what I want to do is read this to you, and then we'll do some commenting about this. Here's what he has to say. I became aware that only life exists, and that darkness and suffering are merely camouflaged love, and that the divine being pervades everything and everybody. But in my own being, love's flame was greatly manifolded. I saw everything material alive, the manifestation of God, his veritable flesh and blood. I caressed the so-called dead as well as living material, mineral as well as animal matter. I loved the stones as well as the sentient beings because they all constituted the body of God, and God's body caressed me. It was as if the golden light, the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, the Father's own consciousness, the sensation of his personal presence as a conscious I close to me, had left everything in an all-penetrating radiance of love. I felt that everything was radiating sympathy within and outside myself. I was being loved by this Father. And with an affection firmly reciprocated, I re-entered the physical world. The sufferings, sorrows, and tribulations of animals and men were again evident to me. The shady zone of existence once more predominated. But above the deep shadows of the darker zone, the golden light kept scintillating in my heart and mind. In my brain and along my spine, I still felt the warmth of the supernatural light. From my hands and my lips, it has already been brought and will continue to be brought to shine in other brains, to vibrate in other spines, to scintillate in other eyes, and to be apprehended by other minds. My word is the torchlight of life. The divine spirit of it lights up in darkness, removes erroneous belief, and brings about the love of God. Everyone living in harmony with this will get to love the Father and will no more be walking in darkness. For loving the Father is equivalent to loving the world, including everything and everybody. This all-pervading love cannot but result in general mental cohabitation. And this again means the perfect satisfaction of our greatest desires, the fullest acquisition of life, the maximal sensation of happiness, the true experience of bliss. And what a gorgeous restatement of the truth. Now, as it turns out, this is precisely and exactly the same as we have heard for thousands of years, at least 5,000 years, the rishis and the seers of the East in areas that we would now call India, although that country didn't exist as that country back then. And the poets and the mystics, the Sufi poets of 600, 700, 800 years ago, down through the ages, people have had these experiences, and they all say the same thing, that what we take as our normal everyday life experience with everything separated from everybody else and some good and some bad and some right and some wrong and whatever is absolutely not the final statement on anything. In all cases, it says, there is something magnificent going on right before our eyes, and we cannot see it. And why can't we see it? Because of our own very limited, very fear-based programming and conditioning. And as all of these restatements of the truth say, our job is not to go try to find love, because it's right here in front of your nose. It's what must we do to remove the blindness so that we can see what's here. A Course in Miracles is merely the latest, very large, comprehensive restatement of this eternal truth. It says the same thing. This course is not about teaching the meaning of love, because that's beyond what can be taught. It does aim, however, at removing the blocks to the awareness of love's presence. And what this man has indicated somewhere in his writings is that he feels like the prerequisite for moving into an experience of this light is a highly developed sense of intuition. Well, we would call that guidance, or the choice to live in your right mind with the Holy Spirit, using the terminology of the Course, the voice of our own deepest loving self, as compared to the ego voice, which is always about the story of me and mine and what I need, and it's all about me to the exclusion of everything else. So the Course, in fact, does do what this man decides is a prerequisite. Now, some people have had these experiences spontaneously and had no idea how it ever occurred to them. But the point is, we're given the option to slowly develop our ability to listen to our own intuition, and we are able more to hear that intuition as we stop being so invested in it's all about me, being more open. The Course is also about bringing into our awareness the limited programming that's in the way, so that as we realize that we're being driven by something that's unhelpful, we have the choice to change our minds. So we have everything we need. The Course talks about perceiving the real world. In other words, we're still here in our time and space, three-dimensional world, but we're able to see the light in everything, which not only this Danish philosopher, but so many other poets, mystics, and seers who directly cognize the truth. They don't learn it someplace. They directly cognize and are aware of it. Everybody's singing the same tune. For thousands of years, we've heard the same thing. There is a loving, light-filled reality right in front of us, and our job is to take off the dark glasses of our own hatred, of our own smallness, of our own confusion, of our own fear. And as we do, as that begins to be traded in for a wider, broader, more loving vision, then we all have at our fingertips the possibility of experiencing exquisite happiness. Seems like now is a great time to rededicate ourselves to that statement where it says, for loving the Father is equivalent to loving the world, including everything and everybody. So as we move into this season of light, It seemed like we should be so newly and wholly dedicated to that goal of, I declare that everything, everybody, despite appearances, despite behavior, is nothing but love incarnate, and to live and act and believe and proceed from that position. My newly found philosopher friend has this to say about his experience. The cosmic baptism of fire through which I had passed, the closer analysis of which I cannot specify here, had thus left the fact that the entirely new sensory abilities had been released in me, abilities that enabled me not in glimpses, but to the contrary, in a permanent state of awake day consciousness, to apprehend all the main spiritual forces, invisible causes, eternal world laws, basic energies, and basic principles behind the physical world. The mystery of existence was therefore no longer a mystery to me. I had become conscious in the life of the whole universe and had been initiated into the divine principle of creation. All of which sounds pretty wonderful and pretty amazing and very desirable. I truly hope you can be excited about this and let this season of light really move in the direction of being more light-filled for all of us. Thanks so much. Have a beautiful holiday.